Barkley Zone.
Polo to...
Did you like that?
Polo to Ernie.
Hello, did you like that?
No, Ernie, I don't think I'm getting the respect and credit I deserve.
I gave you the new thing, the Barkley Zone. Welcome.
Listen.
Welcome to the Barkley Zone.
No wonder we can't get a raise. Y'all wasting money on jump.
Your first trip to the Barkley Zone, isn't it, Kevin?
I'm just more impressed by the board here. You got everything there. You got a lot of sounds. Do you have a zebra in there?
I do not have a zebra. But you're fitting right into the Barkley Zone.
How does
because
a zebra sound?
There's really not one topic.
You know what? I really wanted, we talked about that earlier. I don't know what sound a zebra makes. Why don't you try? I don't, you know, it's like.
Well, what do you think a zebra would sound?
A horse.
Well, it'd be like, something like that.
Okay. That sounded like that'd something be, that was. That was, that was
that'd be the one that was running down the street in
exactly.
Atlanta today.
Yeah, escape from right
the, escape from the circus.
Caused Kenny to come late. Look at that thing.
There you go. And you can see why. So anyway, what we were discussing in the Barkley Zone was, since we have a legendary Celtic here, all-time great Celtic. So we're trying to come up with the top 10. Top
well, this is how the conversation started, Ernie. Okay. On the slam dunk, on three-point shooting contest, All-Star weekend, Kenny said that Paul Pierce was one of the 10 greatest Celtics ever. And Paul Pierce is a terrific player, but I disagree. So I came up with a list. Mm-hmm. Russell.
Okay.
Bird.
For sure.
McHale.
For sure.
Parrish.
For sure.
Havlicek.
Go ahead.
Cousy.
Go ahead.
Collins.
Go ahead.
Dennis Johnson.
Eight. Mm-hmm.
Sam Jones.
Nine.
JoJo White.
10.
Casey Jones.
11.
And I don't.
You don't think Paul Pierce is better than three of those guys?
I do not.
Casey, you don't think he's better than any of those guys?
I do not.
You don't think if he was on those teams the same way that those guys, he would be just as great a contributor as they were?
I think he would have been a contributor. But
they're just as great as a
wait
contributor
a
as not the Bird, McHale, Russell crew.
Well, because Bird, McHale,
and Collins.
Bird,
but the rest.
Hold on. Bird, McHale.
That next five, Sam, if you know, that next five, he's right in
hold
there.
Hold on. Bird, McHale, and Paris is the greatest front line to ever play the game.
That's why
I'm not in that mix.
Well,
but, other than Dennis Johnson, is Dennis Johnson, I think.
I think Dennis Johnson was a better player than Casey Jones.
Well, I don't think that. But I think if you take away Dennis Johnson, who should be in the Hall of Fame.
Yes.
Who should be in the Hall of Fame.
I agree with that.
Is JoJo White in the Hall of Fame?
Yes.
Yes, he is.
Everybody on this list is in the Hall of Fame.
Yes.
So, like, Dennis Johnson should be and everybody else is.
If Paul Pierce was it on any of those teams, he would have been just as major contributor as Sam Jones.
Ooh.
You know, you have, here's the thing.
You have a legendary Celtic here. Yeah, go ahead, weigh in here.
Okay, they're all multiple.
Multiple
NBA champions. All those guys have won, you know, five, six, seven, eight champions. You're talking about Casey Jones and Sam Jones and those guys. In their era, those guys dominated. I mean, dominated game after game, year after year, ran off six, seven NBA titles in a row and walked over people and did it with grit and toughness. And, I mean, I admire those guys so much for how they played and the toughness and their desire to win every single game. Going against Wilt Chamberlain every NBA finals, you know, when he was with Philly and in the conference finals and trying to beat him, beating him in L.A. when he was with the Lakers. So I
that's why I don't
those
touch
guys.
Those guys. I'm not touching any of those guys.
Okay.
I'm not touching the Cowens era, the Sam Jones era, the Bill Russell era. I'm not touching any of those. But when we move into the 80s, after you three guys, if you put Paul Pierce with you guys, he's just as major.
The only guy other than those three in the 80s is Dennis Johnson. When you talk about Bird, McHale, and Perry,
I'm not saying anything.
I'm just saying,
I don't want to say who I should take off, but to me, he's still in my top 10.
I understand that, but you take a Bird.
I'm going to throw a name at you, Charles, and unfortunately, Reggie Lewis died, but had Reggie not passed away.
He would have been a better pro than Paul Pierce.
He was getting into his groove and was making multiple All-Star teams, and I agree, would have been a better player.
When you joined the Celtics, who was the legendary Celtic you looked forward to meeting the most?
Well, there was three of them. It was Tiny Archibald, I was just intimidated by Tiny because he was too quiet. He was really good. And so then there was Pete Maravich, who was just fun and out there. And Dave Collins was, you know, again, a guy we talked about on our list, had already won MVPs of the league and was 6'8". I'm like way bigger than he is. I'm thinking, this guy won the MVP league at center? And so those guys were amazing to go through training camp with. They were just really fun. And as I called home and told my friends, I said, you wouldn't believe Tiny and Pete. I said, and then this Bird guy, he's really good too. And so that just goes to show my first training camp.
Hey, you know what's funny? Every time I see Dave Collins, I tell him, they had to be padding your stats. Because nobody can get that many rebounds. Oh. I mean, when I look at his rebounding numbers, I'm like, nobody could get that many rebounds without them padding them stats.
His MVP year, I think he averaged like 17 or 18 rebounds, and he was 6'8".
I mean,
you know, but tough. I mean, loose balls. He
was
just knock you over.
Chuck, that's what it was.
Tougher than me.
Yeah, he was tough.
That's the.
Man, I beat Dave Collins like he stole it.
Are you? You done with the Barkley Zone?
Yes, we are.
Okay, wait. If you were Celtics, would you be on this list?
Yes.
Oh, big question there.
Yes, he would. He would have won multiple championships, Chuck. You would have been on there.
Oh yeah, I'd be way up there.
There you go.
Is that the?
It sounds like a donkey. Give us a zebra on the way out one more time. That's an ailing zebra.
I don't know exactly.
I don't know.
I never heard a zebra or a giraffe in my life.
Like that's a sickly zebra.
Chain smoking zebra.